Hey guys, this is Project Dave, playing some Monster Hunter World Iceborne. This is probably the last video that's going to go up prior to Sunbreak release, and then we'll be back to Sunbreak for however long. Then maybe come back to Iceborne in the distant future. Not necessarily the distant future, but a few months at least. But this first fight was pretty much the ideal Fatalis fight for wide range, demonstrating some amount of usefulness and keeping the team alive, etc. Which in Rise, if you're fighting like Emergency Apex and Ogre, that's not going to happen. The people will just die. They'll just get one shot. But with Fatalis, maybe they won't get one shot. Sometimes they won't get one shot. Actually, I don't think anything he does one shots if you have good gear, assuming you can break the head before the final phase. So. Not necessarily completely break the head, just partially break the head. So technically wide range is always somewhat useful on Fatalis. And this was a team of, like, Master Rank 100 to 200 instead of the typical Master Rank 999 squad, which is your average Fatalis gear at this point in time. So it was a close fight, that was the point of this. However, there'll be a convenient cut halfway through the fight. I didn't actually die in the fight, so it was still ideal from that point onward for my hands. But I felt like this part demonstrated what I wanted to demonstrate, and then the second part is just a normal Fatalis kill. Not with the most overgeared people ever, but with pretty overgeared people. As opposed to this team, which is not particularly overgeared at all. So. Closer, more interesting fight, followed by the prototypical Fatalis kill 2.0. So, thanks for watching the video, guys. Hope you enjoy it, and I'll see you next time.
around the fort and knock down Fatalis.
Dragonator ready for use.